Hello everyone, welcome to an Epic Games Store Publishing Tool video tutorial. I'm William, and today I'm going to explain to you how to upload your binaries on the Epic Games Store using the BuildPatchTool.
First, you need to log into the developer portal, open your product and get it to the Epic Games Store dashboard. Then select Artifacts and Binaries in the menu on the left. From here, you will get a list of all the offers that have a downloadable content, like the base game, digital goods, DLCs, and demos. To upload your binaries to the Epic Games Store, you will need to use what we call the BuildPatchTool. It is a command line tool that will connect to our servers to upload all your files directly to the corresponding artifacts. Let's grab it by clicking on the button on the top right of the dashboard here. Choose a convenient place to download it and then unpack the zip file. You will be provided with a manual explaining how to use the BuildPatchTool in the extract folder. Feel free to have a look and get more familiar with the tool. There are some scenarios that we will not see in this video that are also explained in the manual. As I said earlier, the BuildPatchTool is a command line press program. I know, this sounds scary, but don't worry. I'm going to explain to you one by one the information you need to provide to upload your binaries without issue. On the Artifacts and Binaries page, select the artifact you want to populate and click on the three dots on the right. Select Manage Artifact. On this screen, you can check the current status of your artifact, change its name, and see which binaries are currently attached to this artifact as well as an history of the binaries you have used in the past. You can also go to the Instruction tab, where you will be explained how to proceed to upload your binaries and where you will also be able to find the prefilled command line template to use with the BuildPatchTool to upload your binaries by clicking on the copy icon here. The information prefilled in this template concerns only the artifact you selected in the previous step, so be sure to copy the template for each artifact you need to upload a binary to. You should get a command line that looks like this. The prefilled information will be your organization ID, the project ID, and the artifact ID. To get your client ID and your client secret, you have to navigate your project settings in the developer portal, then go to the BPT credential. There you will find the BPT client ID and client secret that you can copy to populate corresponding elements in the BuildPatchTool template, just like this. Pay attention to erase the brackets, but keep the quotation marks. Now let's have a look at the other argument. First, the build root argument. This is where the binaries you are trying to upload are located on your computer. For example, I have a UE project, my game, in which I have created a package in this folder, my game package. The build root will then be the path to get to this folder. c/egs/mygame/mygamepackage. I just copy this path and put it for the build root. To avoid any issue with the way the command line will be interpreted, please change all the backslash character for forward slash. This will make things easier. Now the cloud DR argument. This argument can be left empty at first, but this is where information concerning uploaded binaries will be stored on your PC. The path might be different than the build root, as the build patch tool uses it for processing and caching data. You can use any temporary folder for this, like a temporary folder on your C drive. Next is the build version. The version must be unique for each build of a specific artifact, independently of the platform. So you can't use the same version for a Windows build and a Mac build. Since it will be my first version for this game, I'm going to put 1.0. The V for version will be added automatically. Next is the app launch argument. This is the executable file location of your binary, the .exe file for Windows or the Mac or executable file for Mac, usually in the .app folder inside your build root folder. So for example, my executable file is directly at the root of my build root folder, so I will just give the file name, mygame.exe in this example. But if it was in a folder named xfold, my argument would be /xfold/mygame.exe. Please note that if you are uploading binaries for digital extras, you will need to create a little script file for the Epic Game Launcher to open the folder where the extras are stored on the user computer. For more information on how to do this, please see the description below. Apart that you add arguments that will be used when the game is launched by a user. You can leave it empty if you don't have any additional arguments you need to be added. The following arguments are optional arguments and don't need to be in the command line. I invite you to check the documentation in the video's description if you need to use one of these arguments so that the build patch tool ignores some files during the upload. Now that my command line is ready, I need to run it. Start the command prompt as an administrator and search for your build patch tool folder. It should look like this: an engine folder in which you have a binaries folder with a list of operating system folder. I'm working on Windows, so I'm looking for the Win64 folder. Take the path and move to it. For the purpose of this tutorial and to make the command easier to read, I have put arguments on different lines, but to run it, I will need the command line to be on this unique line like this. Now I just need to copy the command line I filled earlier, run it and wait for it to upload my binaries. Depending on the size of the game, this can take some time. The build patch tool will update you with the current progress every few seconds. Once done, let's head back to the artifact and binaries page on the developer portal and check on our base game artifact. As you can see, my build is there, but its list is inactive. What that means is even if I check on Epic Games Launcher and try to download my game, since there is no active binary, I will be welcomed with an unavailable tag. Next step is to make the binary active so that it can be distributed to the dev environment. For that, I will click on the three dots and select Assign Platforms. I upload a binary for Windows, so I check Windows and click Save Changes. Then click on Yes Update to confirm. My binary is now active, or like you might see in the documentation, live. But beware, the build is only available on the dev environment for now. This time we saw how to upload a binary for the first time. When you need to update your game, you will go through the exact same step by uploading your test build and incrementing your version. Doing so, you will see a list of binaries on your artifact page and be able to choose which one is active for the current environment. To make a build available to user for an update, you will need to push the artifact all the way to the live environment like you do for an offer or a page. One last note, once a build is pushed to the live and the game is released, it will start propagating instantly to all the users who possess the game. So be sure that it works properly or you will get in some troubles. That completes our overview of the build patch tool and how to upload your binaries on the Epic Games Store. For more detailed information on this and other topics, check out the documentation. If you have any issues related to the build patch tool, feel free to contact us via the EOS help with the log files attached. Please check in the video description for more details. If you have feedback or other tutorials that you would like us to create, please leave a comment here on the developer community. Thanks for watching and see you soon on the Epic Games Store.